because we started 30 minutes early and we probably get 30 minutes longer than what we normally do. But we are so excited, we are not worried about the time. But we know that we have our students with us tonight and we want to make sure that they are honored and they get to go home on time so that they can get ready for school. With that all said, I will declare our December 11, 2017 meeting to come to order. At this time, we will have the presentation of our colors by Tarver High School AFJROTC group. Thank you very much. You may be seated. At this time, we will have our recognitions and our first person on the program, Susan Hogan.
It is my pleasure to recognize the ECPS Employee of the Month, Jay Axtell, is truly going above and beyond her new role as the digital literacy coach at Phillips Middle School. In addition to transforming the school's learning commons into a space of creativity, collaboration, and problem solving, she is persistently growing a love of reading in all students. After collecting data on student interest, Ms. Axtell completed Donors Choose grants to update the school's book collection. As a result, Phillips Middle School has seen a dramatic increase and the number of books students are checking out. Last school year, Phillips Scholars checked out 369 books total. As of December 1st, Phillips Scholars have already checked out nearly 1,100 books. In addition, Ms. Axtell is a team player who is always willing to step into new roles and take on additional duties to keep the school safe and joyful. Congratulations to the December Employee of the Month, Jay Axtell. Invited to submit artwork to feature on the cover of the ECPS Holiday Card. The winner of the ECPS Holiday Art Contest is Elena Folker, who is a second grade student at G.W. Harwood Elementary School. Her art teacher is Ms. Melinda Costa. Would you both come forward to be recognized? Congratulations, Ms. Pastor Ava. Tonight, we'd like to recognize 11 of our schools who were recently honored at the North Carolina EC Conference last month for implementing positive behavior intervention and support, also known as PBIS. PBIS is a statewide initiative focused on proactive measures for improving social competence and academic achievement for all students. We will begin with the Green Ribbon Schools. Green Ribbon School designations given to schools that have completed the first grade module, have started to implement PBIS, and maintain a minimum score of 80 on the annual school-wide evaluation. I would like to invite the school's principal and PBIS coach to please come forward when your school's name is announced. The first Green Ribbon School is W.A. Patilla Middle School, Principal Lauren Lampard, and PBIS coordinator, Lever Brenner, and assistant principal as well. South Edgecombe Middle School, Principal Billy Struther, PBIS coach, Kim Hampton. Tarver High School, Principal Craig Harris, PBIS coach, James Williams. Congratulations to the Green Ribbon Schools. Model school designation is awarded to schools that have completed the first two modules of training, are actively implementing PBIS, and maintain a score of 90 or above on the annual evaluation. The first model school is GW Bullock Elementary. The principal is Hillary Batwell, PBIS coach Jean Salzberger. GW Carver Elementary, Principal Dr. Shannon DeCijo, PBIS Coordinator Janelle Thompson. Edgecombe Early College High School, Principal Matt Smith, PBIS Coach Gerald Williams. North Edgecombe High School, Principal Donnell Cannon, PBIS Coach Kimberly Collette. Princeville Elementary School, Principal Annette Walker, PBIS Coach Yolanda Jones. Southwest Edgecombe High School, Principal Kevin Cutler, PBIS Coach Cynthia Gibbs. And Stocks Elementary School, Principal Lois Glass, PBIS Coach Twana Diggins. Congratulations to the PBIS Model Schools. Exemplary is the highest level of recognition and reserved for schools that have completed all training, are actively implementing PBIS, and maintain a score of 95 or above on the school-wide evaluation tool.
We have one school that achieved this designation. That's West Edgecombe Middle School. Principal Claude Archer, PEIS coach, Brooke Sides. Very special awards to present to six schools tonight. They have been recognized by the North Carolina Department of Public Instruction for meeting or exceeding academic growth during the 2016-2017 school year. They will be presented with a certificate signed by State Superintendent of Public Instruction, Mark Johnson. The following schools met academic growth during the 2016-17 school year: Martin Millennium Academy, Principal Johanna Parker. And Stocks Elementary School's Principal Lois Glass. We also have three schools that exceeded expected academic growth. North Edgecombe High School, Principal Ronald Keenan. W.A. Utilla Middle School, Principal Lauren Lampron. And Edgecombe Early College High School Principal Matt Skiff. Edgecombe Early College will also be receiving a certificate for their 100% graduation rate. Congratulations to all these schools, their staff members, and their students. Gold Key students are recognized by the Edgecombe County Board of Education for serving as positive role models for their classmates and other young people. They are students who have demonstrated qualities of good character and behavior and have made extra efforts to achieve academic success. Teachers nominate students who may have completed a special community service project or demonstrated special acts of kindness, consideration, or courage. At this time, we'd like to ask for the elementary school students from Carver, Bullock, Coker-Wimberly, Princefield, and Martin Millennium to please move to this aisle in front of the podium to line up. So all elementary students, please move to the aisle to line up. Before we get started, parents, if you'd like to come to the front row and take pictures, please do so. call, please come up the steps and you will receive your certificate from our board chair, Ms. Evelyn Wilson, and our superintendent, Dr. Valerie Griffiths. Please wait on stage for the rest of your school's Gold Key winners so we can take a picture, and then you will exit on the other side of the stage. In order to hear each student's name, please hold all applause until the last student from each school is recognized. From GW Fuller Elementary School, Principal Ms. Hiller Batwell will come forward. The first student is Maya Morales. She's in second grade. She's a wonderful scholar and is dedicated to constant academic improvement. She's always willing to help her teachers and peers with anything they may need while maintaining a sweet, positive attitude. The second student is Ava Phillips. She's in third grade. She strives for greatness in everything she does. Ava is a great friend to others, is patient, and always speaks kindly. She makes good grades and works hard to ensure that she understands exactly what is asked of her. The third student is Maria Rios. She's in fourth grade. She's an enthusiastic learner. She is very passionate about school. She tackles new challenges eagerly and with a positive attitude. She is kind, caring, and friendly. Kiana Brown, she's in fifth grade. She is always prepared for class and goes over and beyond what is expected. She is helpful and guides other students who are struggling. She is a model citizen for her classmates. Congratulations to the Gold Key students from Bullock Elementary School. Congratulations to the Gold Key students from GW Palmer Elementary. Strives to do her best in all things. Tempe Motley, she's in fourth grade. She's a student who is always focused and engaged in her work. She is a role model to not only other fourth graders, but to all students in school who come in contact with her. Jaleel Blue, she's in fifth grade. She's a leader in the classroom who guides her class in a positive direction. Even when the work is challenging, she never gives up. And Jahira Perez Belgar, fifth grade, she constantly displays positive behavior and offers to assist others, other students when needed. Congratulations to the Gold Key students from Frederick Wimberly Elementary School. Amber X. Exum. She's in second grade. She's a positive role model who demonstrates the qualities of self-confidence and leadership. She consistently encourages her peers to be leaders instead of followers. Amber also takes the time for good causes outside of school, such as helping to raise money for the school's PTA. Congratulations to the elementary Gold Key students from Martin Luther Academy. Congratulations to the Gold Key students from Scott County. At this time, I'd like to ask for all the middle school students to please come forward to be lined up. These are students from West Edgecombe, South Edgecombe, Phillips Middle School, Patilla Middle School, and middle school students from Martin Luther County. First middle school is Martin Luther Academy, is Parker, and our Gold Key student, Martin Luther, is Derek Harper. He's in third grade. He is a leader in the classroom. He always has a positive attitude and wants to learn. He consistently helps other students in class when they are struggling. He is also active and willing to participate in community events, both inside and outside of school. Congratulations to Derek Harper. First student is Mia Malpas. She's in sixth grade. She works hard in the classroom and is friendly to to all of her peers. She is respectful to staff members and always willing to help. Brian Montez Molina is in sixth grade. He is a true joy to teach. He is successful and works hard in the classroom today. Jamie Norris, she's in seventh grade. She is a model student academically and with peer relations. She constantly strives to be the best student and person she can be. And Shonderica Harper, she's eighth grade, she's a role model for her peers, and is always focused on her academics and helping others to be their best. Congratulations to the Gold Key students from Attila Middle School. He willingly volunteers as a class helper and is a dedicated student. He truly models the exemplar characteristics that all students should strive for. Manzia Elijah Hedgepath, he's in eighth grade. He is a true servant leader who is always ready to support the improvement of Phillips Middle School. He respectfully advocates for himself and his peers and is willing to do whatever it takes to achieve his goals. And Christian Sharp, she's in eighth grade. She values education and perseveres to consistently earn high grades. She serves as an ambassador to visitors to the school's campus. Congratulations to the Gold Key students from Phillips Middle School. College High School. Principal Matt Smith. Our first student is Brianna Whitehead. She's in ninth grade. She's recognized for her academic dedication and delightful disposition. She strives for excellence in everything she does. Beasia Tula, she's in 10th grade. She displays passion, drive, and talent in all academic areas. She is truly a standout student who impresses everyone she meets with her intelligence, integrity, and dedication. Denia Bray, she's in 11th grade. She is self-motivated and puts her best effort into everything she does. She is courteous, kind, and brings a smile to class every day. Elijah Weeds, he's in 12th grade. He has gone above and beyond as a scholar leader at Edgecombe Harlan College. His participation in the Scholar Teacher Program has taken him to classrooms across the district where he facilitates learning for his students. He is a fine scholar who has earned respect from his peers and teachers. Congratulations to the Edgecombe Harlan College High School GoKey students. Congratulations to the North Edgecombe High School GoKey students. From Southwest Edgecombe High School, Mr. Butler. The first student, Amarian Cooper, he's in 9th grade. He is intelligent, respectful, and well-behaved. I'm delighted to have him in the classroom. Lauren Daly-Williams, she's in 10th grade. She's always willing to go over and beyond in her classes, whether it's class participation or assisting another student. She's an active member of the school's JROTC group and a leader around the school. Matthew Chassie, he's in 11th grade. He's an extremely helpful, functional, and intelligent student. He goes out of his way to help everyone. And Kristen White, she's in 12th grade. She's actively involved with the school's JROTC, yearbook, Operation Smile Club, and multiple athletic teams. She is a dedicated student who is always kind and polite. Congratulations to the GoKey student from Southwest Edgecombe High School. In Charter High School, Mr. Craig Harrison, principal. Our first student is Denia White. She's in 9th grade. She's a big sister to many fellow students who need help. She often tells her classmates that failure is not an option. Our second student is Jordan Johnson. She's in 10th grade. Jordan works hard in the classroom every day. She is a high achiever and a model student at Tarver High. Kevin Knight, he's in 11th grade. He's hardworking and self-disciplined. He personifies what it means to be a distinguished young man. And Kenaya Arnold, she's in 12th grade. She's an outstanding leader of the school. She recently organized a blood drive at the school for the graduation project and is leading a community service project to help the school blood victims. Congratulations to the Charlton High School GoKey students. Let's give one more round of applause for all of our GoKey students.